Welcome to a new episode by Flyboys Aviation. Today's episode is about Ansett Australia. 17 years ago, they disappeared from the aviation scene down under. There is a multitude of reasons why they went bankrupt. The effects of their demise can still be felt to this very day in Australia. See this video to find out the story behind this. The airline was founded as Ansett Airways in 1935 by Reginald Ansett. In the 1940s and 50s, Ansett battled with Australian National Airways and Trans-Australia Airlines in the domestic market. Ansett took over ANA in 1957 and became Ansett ANA, later renamed into Ansett Airlines of Australia in 1968. The two airlines policy by the Menzies government was extremely beneficial to Ansett. With this policy, only TAA and Ansett could operate domestic routes. In 1979, the airline was taken over by TNT and News Corporation. During the 80s, the airline was flourishing. However, the first cracks started appearing as well. The share in America West Airlines that was bought in 1989 performed badly and their Hamilton Island resort went into receivership. The deregulation of the Australian aviation market in the early 90s meant that Qantas, by taking over Australian Airlines, became a direct competitor of Ansett. In the early 90s, they started their first routes to Asia. The Asian financial crisis of 1997 hit their revenues, however. Paying millions of dollars to be the official carrier for the 2000 Sydney Olympics was an expensive move as well. After gaining a majority stake in 1996, Air New Zealand acquired full ownership of Ansett in 2000. It was around this time that Ansett started having serious financial issues. Competition from Qantas, but also from new airlines such as Virgin Blue and Impulse Airlines, became more and more tangible. Expensive staff and an aging fleet didn't help either. Although they had an excellent reputation, the full grounding of their 767 fleet during Easter of 2001 hit their finances and reputation severely. It seemed that it was not incompetence, but irresponsible cost-cutting measures by Air New Zealand that was behind all of this. In early September of 2001, the New Zealand government re-nationalised the airline. When the Australian government made clear they were not going to bail out Ansett, their fate was sealed. There was a great deal of anger pointed at Air New Zealand since many felt they had engaged in asset stripping of the airline and left the airline in ruins. Whether this was actually the case is still unclear. As a result of the downfall of Ansett, Qantas suddenly found themselves without their major competitor. They were fortunate enough to be able to take over a cancelled order of American Airlines for a number of 737s that were delivered just a few months later. This, combined with redeploying part of their international fleet to the domestic scene, meant that they could fill part of the vacuum left by Ansett. Virgin Blue all of a sudden found themselves as the second airline of Australia and quickly expanded as well. As a response to their growth, Qantas launched Jetstar in 2004. So you can see that Australian airports probably would have looked very different nowadays had it not been for Ansett's collapse. Thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. On my channel, you will find a new video every week that delves deeper into the fascinating world of aviation and offers you new insights. See you around!